हेलो ज्ञान स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द सोशल साइंस क्लास लेसन 3 भक्ति कल्ट एंड सूफी हेरिटेज. इन दिस चैप्टर चिल्ड्रन यू आर गोइंग टू स्टडी फ्यू लर्निंग पॉइंट्स. दे आर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशंस ऑफ भक्ति कल्ट, प्रीचिंग्स ऑफ दासास एंड सेंट्स. ओके, इन साउथ एंड नॉर्थ इंडिया अलवार्स एंड दासास, एंड इन नॉर्थ इंडिया संत्स एंड सूफीज क्रिएटेड सोशल अवेकनिंग थ्रू भक्ति कल्ट. Indian society is inclusive of many cultures. In this society, caste system, superstition were deep rooted. It was believed that attaining moksha for the common man was impossible. During this period, saints of Bhakti cult and Sufi tradition brought in a social and religious reformation. They stressed the importance of global brotherhood and taught that bhakti is the best way to attain moksha. This path is called bhakti cult. Now let us learn one by one. First is Andal. You can observe the picture, children. Andal is one among the 12 Alvars, means the Vishnu devotees of Tamil Nadu. She was an adopted daughter of Vishnu Chitta. Andal's original name was Godadevi. They were devotees of Krishna. Andal loved Krishna and she claimed that he was her husband. She wrote Tirupame and dedicated to God. Now the next picture is Akka Mahadevi. Akka Mahadevi was an enterprising woman in the Vachana movement of 12th century. She was born in Uduttadi of Shivamogga district. She claimed Channamallikarjuna himself to be her husband. She stayed at Anubhava Mantapa. There she wrote many vachanas under the pen name of Channamallikarjuna. Now next is Purandara Dasa. He is one of the important persons in Kannada Dasa literature. Purandara Dasa was born in Purandara Gada. His original name was Srinivasa Nayaka and his wife Lakshmi Bai was a religious woman. He distributed all his wealth to the needy people and spent rest of his life in the thought of God. He traveled to many places singing kirtanas. At last, he took Diksha by Vyasaraya and called as Purandara. Purandara Dasa condemned caste system. We also see the combination of philosophy, moral and musical qualities in his songs. So only he is known as Karnataka Sangeeta Pitamaha, means father of Carnatic music. He wrote Kirtanas with the pen name of Purandara Vitala. Next is Kanakadasa. Kanakadasa is one of the famous Kirtanakaras of Dasa literature. He was born at Bada village of Bankapura taluk in Haveri district. Timmappa was his original name. It said that he found a pot full of gold and he came to be known as Kanakanayaka. Later, he came to be known as Kanakadasa and he has composed many kirtanas with a pen name of Adikeshava. Next is Shishunala Sharifa. Shishunala Sharifa is the first Kannada Muslim poet. He is known as Kabira of Karnataka. He was born at Shishunala and he studied both Hindu and Islamic religion in his childhood. He took Diksha from Govinda Bhatta and wrote many Tattvapadas. Now is Kabir Das. Kabir Das is a famous saint of Bhakti cult and was a disciple of Ramananda. He tried to bring harmony between Hindu and Muslim religions. And also he said, Allah and Rama are the two names of one God. According to him, it is not possible to see God by fasting, torturing the body. It is only possible by devotion. And his followers are called Kabir Pantis. Next is Guru Nanak. Guru Nanak is the founder of Sikh religion. He was born at Talwandi in Punjab. Now it is in Pakistan. His songs called as Japji are in Granth Sahib, Sacred Book of Sikhs. He said, one can gain Guru through Bhakti and with Bhakti one can attain Mukti. He opposed social evils like idol worshipping, casteism, sati system, etc. Next is Tulasidas. Tulsidas was the first to support Bhakti Marga in North India. He was born in a Brahmin family. He has contributed to the Hindi literature. He wrote Ramacharitamanasa. This is a great book in Hindi in the North. It is famous as Tulsi Ramayana. Rama Bhakta Tulsidasa. He sowed devotion, pure life, love, affection, patience among the people. Next is Mirabai. Mirabai is a renowned saint of India and is called as Radha of Kali Yuga. She was born in a Rajput family in Rajasthan. She loved philosophy from her childhood. She spent her time in offering puja, meditation and singing. Her songs are full of devotion and love. Giridhara Gopala is her favorite god. Now next is Chaitanya. Chaitanya was born in Naradvipa in Bengal. Vishwambara was his original name. Chaitanya left his family life and took sannyasa at the age of 25. He rejected casteism. Bhakti is the only way to attain mukti. He traveled to pilgrimage places of India and spread the message of love. The Bengalis call him Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Like Kabir, Kanakadasa, Chaitanya and others brought in new awareness among the Hindus. Like that only Sufi saints brought awareness among the Muslims. The word Sufi comes from the word Saf, which means clean and clear. Let us learn about Nizamuddin Aliya. He is one of the main Sufi saints. He lived in Delhi and lived a life of poverty. He refused the village gifted by Sultan of Delhi. He preached to the devotees who visited him to practice good qualities and kindness. Khwaja Bande Nawaz. Bande Nawaz is a famous Chishti Sufi saint. He was the disciple of Nasiruddin of Delhi. Bande Nawaz means protector of those who came to his shelter. He settled in Kalburgi. He was respected by the King Firoz Shah. He wrote in Dakani language. His literature is still preserved in Kalburgi Library. Next is Chishti sect. In Sufi cult, Chishti sect is important. Moinuddin Chishti is the founder of this. He came and settled in Ajmera. Devotion towards God, service to Guru, good life are the main features of Chishti followers. He had concern for harmony of Hindu and Muslim.
Thank you for watching the video. If you really liked our video, click on the like button, share and do subscribe. From Gnanajyoti team, alone we can do so little, together we can do so much. For further information, kindly visit our website, that is www.gnanajyoti.com.